A stunning day in British Columbia for cross country and the women's team sprint. And the Swedish supporters in buoyant mood because their duo were the favourites. And this was their semi-final. And right from the gun, Charlotte Kalla shooting into the lead. Kalla, the 10-kilometer freestyle champion, and her teammate Anna Haag, the silver medalist in the pursuit. They'd ski alternate laps of 1.4 kilometers, the pair of them covering three laps each. And their task made a little easier because some of the big names weren't taking part. Marit Bjørgen of Norway, already a double gold medalist, saving herself for the two events to come. Likewise, Justyna Kowalczyk of Poland, the world number one. And Slovenia's Petra Majic, taking a rest after her big fall in the warm-up for the pursuit. So Sweden, easy winners in this first semi-final, with Norway coming in second, followed by the United States. Those three teams qualifying for the final, Canada, the host nation, just missing out in fourth place. The other semi-final looked harder to call, with Italy, France and Germany amongst the nations in good form. And one other team to watch here, Russia, with Irina Kozova leading off for them. Her teammate was Natalia Korostaleva, a fine sprinter. Italy also starting out strongly. But at the end of six laps, it was France, with Laura Barthélemy rounding off the good work by 35-year-old Karine Laurent-Philippot. France winning the second semi-final, with Italy and Germany in second and third. Poland, Russia and Finland also qualifying as the fastest losers. And so the team sprint final. With Sweden, the defending Olympic champions, still looking like the team to beat, they were the quickest of the qualifiers. And again, it was Charlotte Kalla who shot straight into the lead. The 22-year-old standing only 1 meter 62 tall, but she proved what she could do by taking the first cross-country gold of the games. And Kalla leading the pack up the hill for the first time, with a real scramble behind her. And disaster for France. Philippot getting her skis tangled up, the Americans getting blocked, and Norway too. But it was the French who suffered the most, because that was effectively the end of their challenge. Kalla still leading for Sweden, with Finland in second place as they approached the 1.4 meter mark and the first exchange. And Charlotte Kalla would hand over to Anna Haag, the rules dictating she'd have to touch her without obstructing any other team. And Sweden trying to take the fire out of their opponents at an early stage. But by the last lap, they still hadn't managed to shake off Germany, as Claudia Neustadt forced herself to the front. She'd already taken the lead once, but Anna Haag had retaliated with less than a kilometer to go. Now, Neustadt was digging in, and Sweden were about to lose their Olympic title. Afterwards, Neustadt would thank the Swedish pair for making the pace and stretching the field. She said it allowed her to ski in a relaxed fashion. Well, the finish certainly wasn't too relaxed, but Claudia Neustadt hung on, and she would cross the line in first place, with Anna Haag just behind in second for Sweden, and Russia beating Italy to the bronze medal. But it was joy for Germany, for Neustadt, and for Ebi Sackenbacher-Steller. Both had won an Olympic silver in the individual sprint. Sackenbacher-Steller in 2002, Neustadt in 2006. Now they've done even better together as a team. Silvers to Charlotte Kalla and Anna Haag, both collecting their second medals of the Vancouver Games. And bronze to the Russians, Kozova and Korostaleva, who'd hounded the leaders for much of the race but couldn't produce the kick at the end. The winners, though, the German duo, who, as Neustadt said, were a deadly combination.